So I made a painting called The Deadheads, which started from the title, and then from that title, and in like a series of stages, I then brought in different references that I was sort of associating with that title. And so the end painting had this kind of like internal logic where all these references had been brought together, and they only existed together because of the internal logic of this painting. But the directions in which they referenced the outside world kind of felt a bit superfluous, and I was a bit uncomfortable with them sort of existing outside of the painting. And so I wanted to make a painting that of an object that was using all the sort of representational ways of using paint, but was much more careful in how it actually referenced the outside world. The things that exist to be presented, or things that exist to be displayed. For example, in my painting, The Deadheads, it has these heads, which comes from an etching, or a very old etching, of some heads on spikes that they've, after they've been executed, and they're there to be presented to the public, and they're there to be displayed, which kind of correlates with what the function of the painting is. It's an object that's there to display an image, and so I'm quite interested in using things that correlate with the function of a painting. I decided to shed lots of colours and just use two colours, or maybe three colours, because that's all that you only need a light colour and a dark colour to start to carve out 3D space within on the 2D surface. And that's sort of like the principal way that painting has always made 3D spaces, by something called grisaille, where it's just monochrome painting. It's just using one colour, one dark colour and white, and then that was the principal way of carving out the space. Kind of maybe yes and no. No, because I don't think it's necessarily true, because I think that like the shape that painting takes is often not something that necessarily the field or the medium of painting decides. I think the shape that contemporary painting takes is often moulded by the world around it. And so, you know, things happen in the world, and then and so today, maybe the relationship that we have to images through social media and the internet and the computer screen, I think that is kind of shaping our relationship to images, and in the negative space, that's kind of where painting exists. And so it has maybe a quite indirect link to the world of images at large.